Welcome back, my dear students. So today we will learn about the log gates. Okay, so it is comes under your module 2 only. So total pressure and center of pressure on log gates. So what are these log gates? So what are the forces acting on the log gates? Everything in detail we know in this session. So I am Chandrakant. I am lecturing on my channel Civil Knowledge. So we will directly enter the concept. So before knowing about the log gates, we'll just visualize some of the examples of these log gates. So as you see in the picture, so these pictures and whatever the videos and they are playing here are all taken from the internet and FM Fluid Mechanics by R.K. Bansal textbook. Okay, now so this the images are also taken from the internet. Okay, so see here, this is the log gates. So a water body is present here. So boat can be seen here, right? So this is the water body, which may be a river or a lake. Okay, so it is connected with the canal. Okay, this canal, then when it is constructed, no, the canal, the water will be rushed inside the canal. Then to stop the water, okay, to retain it, the log gates are used. Okay, see the water level here, the water level here and the water level here. So here you can clearly see the water level is H, but here the water level is more than, greater than H. So one of the function of log gates, what we can tell, it is used to maintain the water level. Okay, so here in this picture you can see the log gates. So this is on bigger channel, I think so, or a lake or something, what it is, a water body. So the water is entering here, so the log gates are provided here. So the log gates are also provided to maintain or to give the navigation for ships or boats. Okay, so the log gates are mainly for the purpose of to navigate any ships or boats through the water bodies and also to maintain the water level. Okay, see, I'll play a video here. And this also taken from the internet, courtesy internet. So when once you see the video, you will get an idea, rough idea about the log gates. So before playing this, see, this is the where the log gates is connected. No, so this is called hinge. This hinge action will make the log gates to rotate. Okay, here also hinge is there, here also hinge is there. This person is was doing inspection of this log gates. Okay, so once you see the video, see the log gates are opening. So opening, so the ship is moving, and after going, it's again closing. So an animation is done. So the log gates, water body is there, log gates. Two log gates are there. So this is the plan view, how the log gates are visualized from upward. Whenever we see like this, see the shape you see of the log gates. Okay, so once the purpose is fulfilled, it is closed. See, this man is showing. So see the shape. Okay, again, once the surface it is filled, it is again closed and the water is free to move, or any water motor is free to move. So this is the system of the log gates. Okay, so it is closing. So once it is closed, it is fixed to the dimension only. Fine. So I want to show you another here. See, these are the log gates. So when the log gates are closed in this position, okay, see, this is the plan view. Before that, I want to show you. So this is the part, it is called hinge. wherever it is connected. It is called as hinge. Okay, and once this is in open position, so once it is closed, so I'll show you. Once it is closed, okay, see, then it is called the common point. So a point is created. So this is the common point P. Okay, common point B. Any name you can give, but once it is touched or when it is closed, a common point will be there. Okay, so this is hinges and a common point, and this is what width of this opening, and this is the width of the gate. So this is the width of the gate. So due to this hinge, what will happen? A reaction is developed here. So that's called R. Okay, and due to the common point here, another reaction is developed, and we will name it as P. So P to be in equilibrium, it is to be in a equilibrium force. So P, the force P should be in equilibrium. If the P should be in equilibrium, equal and opposite forces should be acting. Okay, equal and opposite forces should be acting at a point P to be in equilibrium. We'll get to know once I enter the topic. Okay, just you know, these are hinges and here is the common point P, and it is the plan view. Whenever we see from the upper side, it is the plan view. Okay, if I see here and I watch like this, it will become what? Elevation. Okay, if I see from here, well, you'll get to know. Fine. Okay, so now we will see the purpose. So why it is used. So it's okay, we'll solve. See here, we'll see the purpose of the navigation. Log it, see, ship has come, the log gates are open. See the water level, please have a note on the water level. So the water level is now decreasing. When it is in level with the water level with here, then the log gate will open, then the ship will move. And again, when the ship comes back, what it will do, it will come here, the ship will come here, then again this log gate will be open because the water level is same. Then it is going to the intermediate point, then the water level should be again maintained to the water level which is going to the forward side, right? So once the level is satisfied, then this log gate also open, then the ship will move. So whatever may be the purpose, just these log gates are also used to maintain the water level, and also it allows the water motors to navigate through the water body. This was about the log gates. Now we will see the definition one by one. See, this is the plan view. So we will do the detailing of this diagram. This is the plan view. So looking from the upward, what I should know. So these are the hinges A and C. At a point, A and C are what? Hinges. And B is the point, common point, where it meets in a closed position. Whenever it is in closed position, then only any reaction, if it is developed, means it will develop. If it is open, no reaction. If it is closed, then reaction will develop. So whenever I see from here, then what I can see? I can see the elevation of this plan. So what is the elevation? So the water surface is at a depth of h1. Okay, here the water surface is at a depth of h2, and the force, F force, will always be, whatever the force, this force will always be normal or perpendicular to the surface. Keep it in mind, the force, this is the log gates, so the force will be perpendicular, the force will be perpendicular to the log gate. Okay, so both side water is there, okay, but the level of water is different. So here, if we take F1 as the force from the water surface in this side, this F1 force will act at a distance of h1 by 3, at a depth of h1 by 3. This is the assumption here. And F2 will also be act at the depth of h2 by 3. Okay, F2 will act at h2 by 3, F1 will act at h1 by 3. So these are the hinges. Okay, due to that hinges, and whenever it is in closed position, reaction will be developed. So if this is bottom, so I will take is RB, reaction at the bottom. So at C means we will take the reaction at the top. Okay, from these both reaction we can calculate the resultant reaction later. So this was about the diagram. Okay, next we will see. So what are these loggates? So loggates are the devices used for changing the water level in a canal or a river for navigation purpose. Fine. So this is the plan already we discussed. So we will detail it. So what is this? Let AB and BC are the two loggates. This AB, okay, and BC are the two loggates. Each gate is supported on two hinges on their top and bottom at A and C. So in the closed position, the gate meets at B. Correct? In the closed position, the gate meets at B. So this is about the this diagram. Next, we'll know the forces. So F is the resultant force due to water. So what is this? F is the resultant force due to water on the gate AB. So due to symmetry, so this BC and AB, due to symmetry, we will analyze only one part of the gate. Okay, so when we take that gate also, same forces will be there. Okay, due to the symmetry, we will analyze only one gate. So when you consider this gate, next what we do, so let R be the reaction at the lower and upper hinge. Let R be the, this is the resultant reaction. If we take at bottom, it is called RT. If we take at upper hinge, it is called as RB. So reaction at top, reaction at bottom hinge. So whenever it is in closed position at B, the reaction at a common contact surface of the two gates and acting perpendicular to the contact surface. So this is the contact surface. The P reaction is created, and this P will act like this with respect to the gate AB, and with respect to the gate BC, it will act like this. But to solve here, what we are doing, we are considering only the half of the gate. Okay, only one gate we are using, not this BC and AB both. Only the AB gate we are using to calculate the reaction forces. Now, let the P and F meet at O. So what they are telling, so I'll show here, this is what A and B. So if I am writing, this means this is in closed position. The gate AB is in closed position. Okay, whenever it is closed, what will happen? So here in this point and this point, reactions are developed, and this reaction is called as what? R, and this reaction is called as P. Okay, and the force, the resultant force will act at perpendicular. This is F. F is the force perpendicular to the or normal to the surface AB. So I am writing with the mouse, so it is being difficult. Okay, so F is the force acting normal to AB, P is the force due to the close contact, this P will be perpendicular to the contact surface. So whenever we enhance it or we enlarge it, so this will meet at O. Okay, and due to O and due to this R is in equilibrium, okay, this gate AB is in equilibrium, what we do, this R will also meet at O, okay, this is reaction, okay. So then the reaction R must pass through O as the gate AB is in equilibrium under the action of three forces. What are the three forces? P, F and R are the three forces. Now let theta be the inclination. So this is the theta. So let theta be the inclination of the lock gate with the normal to the side of the lock. So it is normal to the side of the lock. So due to the property of what? Triangle. Okay. Not property of triangle. Due to the property of what? The alternate angles. So this is theta means this is also theta. If this is theta due to the property of triangle, this is also theta because AB is in equilibrium. So these are the sides of a triangle. So due to the property of triangle, this is also theta and this is also theta. See here, this is also theta and this is also theta. So when we see here, what is formed? A triangle is formed. What is that triangle? The triangle name is triangle A, triangle ABO. Okay, in triangle ABO. So what we can tell? Angle OBA, angle OBA, angle B is equal to angle A, which is equal to what? Theta. Okay, how we can write that? I'll show you in the next slide. So in triangle ABO, angle OAB is equal to angle ABO, ABO. Okay, angle ABO and OAB are theta. Now what we have to do? We have to resolve the forces, because these forces are along with the AB. We have to consider the analysis along the AB, along the gate AB. So if the gate is like this, right? See here. We have to resolve the forces along AB. Okay. So this is A and this is B. But here P is what? P is like this. Okay. Then R is what? R is also like this. Somewhere here. Okay. It's like this. Okay. The reaction R is like this and the reaction P is like this. What we have to do? We have to take along AB, along this direction. So whenever we have to take along AB, along a plane AB, what we have to do? We have to resolve the forces. We have to take in this direction. Okay. Now we have to do, we have to resolve the forces. So see here, concentrate. So P is this force, right? So this P I taken here, P. So along AB means the P will act here. This is along AB and this is what? Theta. If it is along AB, another will be another force we want, right? This is P. I am resolving this force into horizontal and vertical. So one is I took, another I have to take, which is 90 degree to this one, or which is perpendicular to this one. So this is with the angle theta. So what I can take, that is R. It's not R. So this is what? P, right? This is P cos theta. Why? It is with the angle theta. So along AB, this is along AB, AB, the angle is P cos theta. Another side here is there, no? What is this? This is P sine theta, P sine theta. Okay, this is along AB, this is along perpendicular to AB, means it is perpendicular to, means it is normal to AB, it is in the direction of this force F. Okay, along with the force F, we have P sin theta, along AB we have P cos theta. Similarly, at R, so R is like this, no? Okay, at R, what did we have solved here? So we'll get this R and this R. So this theta we know. So I'll write again. So this is the actual R is this. Okay, so this is the angle theta. So it is upward, right? So the R will be upward here. So this is what? R cos theta. Okay, and again another force will be in the direction of the force F, that is R sin theta. So R is resolved now. So this is our R. So this is angle theta. So R will be along AB R cos theta. Okay, along another direction it will be R sin theta. So here direction is very important. See, it is going upward and P is coming downward. Okay, with this what we can do, we can resolve the forces along the gate AB. When we do resolve the forces along the case AB, what we can do? So this R cos theta is what? Upward. So you can take it as positive R cos theta. So this is coming downward. What is this? P cos theta is coming downward. No, here P cos theta. So P cos theta is minus P cos theta. And then any other forces are there on the AB? No force, is equal to zero. When R cos theta is equal to P cos theta, cos theta, cos theta get cancels, then we get R is equal to P. Okay, R is equal to P. This was the forces along the gate AB. Fine. Now what we have to do? We have to resolve the forces along another direction. What is that? Along the force F. Okay. Now what we can do? See, this is AB, right? AB. This force is here. And here one reaction is there, here one reaction is there. So I'll write the same reaction, same notation. So F is there. Then here what is there? R sin theta is there. R sin theta is there. Here what is there? P sin theta is there. P sin theta. And also they are telling this AB is in equilibrium. Okay. So whenever you take two forces, what you did in your first year, here on force is given, what you were doing, you were equating with, this is in equilibrium, what you have to do, we have doing upward forces is equal to downward forces, upward forces is equal to downward forces, right? This upward force is equal to downward force. Then what, if for example this is what I can take, one minute. Okay, now this is what I can take it as some value C. Okay, some value D. This is what P. Then what we can do, upward force is equal to downward forces. This P is equal to C plus D we were doing. Okay, this an arrow, we are changing the sign. Okay, upward forces, whatever the upward forces is equal to the downward forces. And what is the surface? This is the surface. Okay, same concept we are using here. Okay, same concept. What happens means here, see, your R cos theta or R sin theta, in the, we are resolving in the forces normal to the gate AB, perpendicular along the AB. Okay, it's done. Now we have to take, resolve the forces along the, or normal to the surface. Then what will happen? Then it is nothing but R sin theta, R sin theta plus P sin theta is equal to, these forces are equal to what? This force F. Okay, then this F is equal to what? F is equal to this. R is equal to P, right? This I can substitute as P only. Okay, then P sin theta plus P sin theta is nothing but 2P sin theta. Okay, 2P sin theta. What I need? okay, F is equal to 2P sin theta. But what I need this reaction P. So P is equal to F divided by sin theta. So this is the equation to calculate the value of P. Okay, and this P can be calculated when we know the value of F and also this theta. Okay, now see, resolving the forces to the normal, forces normal to the gate AB is what? R sin theta plus P sin theta minus F is equal to 0. So F is equal to R sin theta plus P sin theta. So P is equal to F by 2 sin theta. Now, to calculate the equation P, we should know the value of F and this theta. So the value of theta is calculated from the angle between the log gates. So the angle between the log gate is, so if we take this as theta, here also theta will be there. Okay, when we take this full length, what is that? It is 180 degree. So 180 degree minus this is 2 theta. So 180 degree minus 2 theta madidre inge adu. So the sum of the angles in the triangle is what? 180 degree. So here also theta, here also theta. See, so this is the triangle. Okay, sum of the angles is 180 degree, right? So here also theta, here also theta. Namage ee angle beku, ee angle enagutte, so 180 degree minus 2 theta. So from this value we can find the value of theta, hence theta can be calculated, and the value of F is calculated by our what? Our hydrostatic force equation, that F is equal to rho g into h1, the same formula. Okay, now because it is hydrostatic force na from the water, so same formula I will show you. So let first we'll define this figure. H1 is what? Height of the water on upstream side. H2, height of the water in downstream side. F1, so F1 is the force, water pressure on the gate stream at the upstream side. F2 is the water pressure on the gate on the downstream side. L is the width of gate. Okay, now what we can do, F1 is equal to rho g A1 into H1. So rho g into A1 into H1 bar. So rho g is constant. Okay, we have to calculate this A1. A1 is what? Surface area. We want only the surface area. So what is the surface area? This height H1, height into length of the gate, here given to see. A1 is what? H1 into L. Surface area is H1 into L1. So H1 bar, where it, what is the centroid? H1 bar is what? COP. H1 by 2. So H1 by 2 is your H1 bar. Similarly, here also A2. If we take the A2, what it will be? H1 into L1, L, right? It will be H2 into L. Okay, A2 will be H2 into L, and H2 bar will be H2 by 2. Just substitute, you will get the answer. So rho g H1 into L, H1 by 2. So rho g L into H1 square by 2. This is F1, the force. F1, that's the water pressure on the gate on the upstream side. Now F2, rho g A2 into H2, so same rho g H2 into L, H2 by 2, rho g L into H2 square by 2. So this is the F1 and F2, water pressure on the gates on upstream side and water pressure of the gates on downstream side. Just I took the formula, just I substituted whatever the detailing I have in the diagram, just I substitute with them. So now I know the value of F1 and F2. F1 and F2. But what I need? I need what? Resultant force. This force I need. This force I need, which will act upon the gate. Okay? Due to both sides, water will be there. I want the resultant force. How to find this resultant force? We have the formula. What is that? F is equal to F1 by 2. So the resultant force will be F is equal to F1 by 2. So substitute that, rho g L into H1 square by 2 minus rho g L into H2 square by 2. Now, we have to substitute the value of theta and f in this equation. The value of p and r can be calculated. Okay, once we get this force f, we can substitute our value of f here. If we substitute the value of f here, we can get the value of p, and also if we resubstitute above, we will get the value of r. Okay, once we know the value of p, once we know the value of f by the procedure which we done know, by that we will get the value of f. Okay, so from that we can substitute the value of theta and also f, and we can calculate the value of p. Correct. Now what we are doing, we have to find the reactions at the top and bottom hinges. So whatever the reaction I told you, the reaction at the top hinge will be RT and the reaction at the bottom hinge will be RB. So the total reaction will be RT plus RB will be your total reaction. So the resultant water pressure F acts normal to the gate. So whatever the reaction or force, whenever we talk wholly about the resultant force, resultant reaction, these all the forces will act normal to the gate. Here one assumption is there. Whenever it will act, see, the resultant force F acts normal to the gate. Half of the value of F, whatever the force we get here, okay, this F is resisted by the hinges. Okay, this F is resisted by the hinges of one lock gate, and other half will be resisted by the hinges of other lock gate. So the F is shared by two lock gates, because two gates are there, na? So half of the value of F is resisted by hinges of one lock gates, and other half will be resisted by the hinges of the other lock gates. And also this F1 will act at H1 by 3 at a depth of H1 by 3. This is the assumption. And F2 will act at H2 by 3. Okay, F1 will act at H1 by 3, F2 will act at H2 by 3. Okay, this resultant force R, to get this resultant force R. Now, what we have to do? Now, we will take the moments about the lower hinge. So, I'll show you. So, we will take the moments here. Okay, why we are taking moments? To get the values of R. Okay. We will take the moment about the lower hinge. I will show you. 1 minute. So let me clear this. So now we will take the moments about the lower hinge. So what is this lower hinge? I will try to show you. So we know point. So this is the point. Okay. So this is the point. So first I'll show you the diagram where it is. See, here hinges are there, no? Hinge. So this is the bottom hinge, RB. This is the upper hinge, RT. Okay. So what were the forces? So whenever this is the hinges, right? So RB was how the reaction was there? So RB was like this, right? Okay, similarly RT will be like this. Okay, so whenever we need, we have to resolve this. Okay, resolving in this shape. Whenever we take RT, we have to resolve in this shape along the BC. Whenever RB, we have to take along the AB. Okay, so remember, so when we resolve the RT, what it will be? So RT will be, so the RT sin theta, it will come like this. Okay, so it is in the closed form. Whenever it is, 1 minute, I'll erase it. So just see, so this is the hinge. Okay, so this RT, due to the, it is an inclined force, right? So one force will be like this and another force will be like this. Here also one force will be like this and another force will be like this. This is bottom hinge RB, this is top hinge RT. Okay, when it's inline. Okay, now we know the angle also. So what we can call is, this is RT, this is RB, this is the resolved forces. So this resolved forces will be RT, because we know the value of theta here. This is RT cos theta and this is RT sin theta. Same way, RB sin theta, this is RB cos theta. Now what I am doing, I am taking the moment about RB, taking the moment about the lower hinge RB. Okay, whenever I take the moment about RB, what will act? This RB will act, this RT will act. So this RT sin theta into this distance. What is the distance? This distance is given by h. Okay, width between the hinges is h, we will take. Okay, so this RT sin theta into h is equal to the forces. Here the force will act now, F1, and that force, how it will act? It will act half of that forces. So F1 by 2 will act here at a distance of H1 by 3. And here, this side, F2 force will act. And F2, we are taking only one of the logarithm. No? So F2 by 2, it will act at where? H2 by 3. It will act at H2 by 3. ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದೀನಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಈ ಲಾಗ್ ಗೇಟ್ ಇರ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ, ಈ ಇಕ್ವಿಲಿಬ್ರಿಯಂ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟಿ ಸೈನ್ ಥೀಟಾ, ದ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬಿ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ಅದು ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಇರ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು, ಆರ್ ಟಿ ಸೈನ್ ಥೀಟಾ ಇಂಟು ಎಚ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ದ ಫೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ದಟ್ ಗೇಟ್. ಸೊ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಟೆಲ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್. See, taking about the lower hinge will prone down again. RT sin theta, this RT sin theta into the distance is what? H. This is the moment, right? About here. RT sin theta into H. So the H is the distance between the two hinges, is equal to F1 by 2. So where this point I am getting? From here. Backslide, you are taking that here, no? So also F1 acts at a distance of H1 by 3 and F1 is, half of the F1 is acting only, half of the value of F is registered by the hinges. Okay, we are concerned with the hinges only. So F1 by 2 will act at H1 by 3. F2 by 2 acts at H2 by 3. Keep that in mind. So RT sin theta into H is equal to F1 by 2 into H1 by 3 minus F2 by 2 into H2 by 3. So where H is the distance of between two hinges. So resolving these forces horizontally. So resolve, whenever we resolve the forces in horizontal. So this RT sin theta. So RT sin theta, which we here know. So whenever there is two hinge, here RT sin theta will be there. Here RB sin theta will be there. So this RT sin theta plus RB sin theta is equal to what? F1 minus F2. F1 minus F2 is nothing but the force. The force resisted, the force increased, the force which is given by the water, the resultant force experienced by the water, the force, water in the bandha force, resultant force, this force is created by the water. It should be equal to what? The resultant force R, so that the logarithms will be stable and they are free to function. So, from equations this 1 and 2, we can find the value of RT and RB. So, this is the equation. So, the gates to be in equilibrium, this condition should be satisfied. RT sin theta plus RB sin theta is equal to F1 by 2 minus F2 by 2. Okay. So, this derivation they will not ask. Okay. Just to know the information I told you. So this was about the log gates. Intention is to find the p value, f value, r value. Okay, if these three values we need to find, so that if by these three values we can tell the gates are in equilibrium or not. So now we'll see one example. Okay, so problem number one. So each gate of lock is 6 meter height and is supported by two hinges placed on top and bottom of the gate. So each gate is 6 meter high, see, 6 meter height, and is supported by two hinges placed on top and bottom of the gate, supported by two hinges top and bottom. When the gates are closed, see, they are giving the angles only. When the gates are closed, they make an angle 120 degree. So they are directly telling they will make an angle 120 degree. The width of the lock is 5 meter. The width of the lock is 5 meter. If the water levels are 4 meter and 2 meter, so here 4 meter and 2 meter, determine the magnitude of the forces on the hinges due to water pressure. We have to determine what the forces F and also the reaction R, whether it is the resultant force bekandre F1 F2 kandidibeku, resultant reaction bekandre RT and RB should be found out. Okay, now we'll solve this problem. So here, when the gates are closed, they are giving 120 degree directly. So what we can take, so 180 degree minus 120 degree, what it will give? It will give 60 degree, right? So we know that central angle is 180 degree minus 2 theta. Okay, this 2 theta is equal to what? This 2 theta is equal to 60. Then theta is equal to what? 30 degree. So here 30 degree is there now. This 30 degree is found by this. Why I found this 30 degree? To the length of the gate is not given. So I want this length of the gate. So this will form what? Right angle triangle. So I know this length AB. Okay. And I know this value theta. So then I can find the value of AB using the property of trigonometry. Okay. Now we'll see the given. So height of the lock is 6 meter. Width of the lock is 5 meter. Width of each gate is not given. It is taken as AB. Okay, so this AB can be found out by L is equal to, this L, AB is length of the gate is nothing but AD by cos 30 degree. AD is what? 2.5 divided by cos 30 degree. This figure is given in the question only. Okay, so 2.5 by cos 30 degree is 2.887 meter is the width of the gate. Now angle between gates is given, it's already explained to you, 30 degree. So height of the water on upstream side, h1 is 4, h2 is 2 meter. This is the height of the water on upstream side. This is the height of the water on downstream side. Okay. So this was the given data for this problem. Now what we have to find? We have to find the total water pressure on the upstream side. What is that? F1 we have to find. So you have to compare with the standard diagram which I solved in the first session, no, in this session only, no, the before slides we have to find, that is the standard diagram, we have to compare with that. So F1 is what? The total water pressure on the upstream side, and F2 is what? Total water pressure on the downstream side. What is the formula? So rho g, already known formula, a into h1 bar. So what is this a1? A1 is nothing but h into L, height into the length of the gate. What is h1? h1 by 2 means 4 by 2 is 2. Okay, once we substitute this, we will get this F, no problem. Then about F2, rho g A2 into H2. Similarly, you can do that also. A2 is what? H2 into L. H2 is what? 2 meter. 2 into this 2.887 we do means I will get A2, and also the H2 is what? H2 bar. Okay, here I did, and this forces, this F1 forces will act at 4 by 3 means H1 by 3. this F2 force will act at 2/3. We have to compare with that standard diagram which I discussed in the previous slide. So this force will be acting at h/3, okay, whatever it may be, F1 or F2, whatever the force, it will act at the height divided by 3. So now, so total water pressure on the upstream side is what? F1 is equal to rho g A1 into H1 bar. So A1 and H1 bar we already calculated. So 1000 into 9.81 into 4 into 2.887 into 2. So it is your F1 is 22,657 Newton. Okay. Now the force F1 will be acting at H1/3. Important. Okay. 4/3 it is 1/1.33 meter from bottom. Similarly, the total pressure on the downstream side is what? F2 is, we have to calculate this, then we are getting the value of H2 is 1 meter. Then this F2 will also act at H2/3. Okay, so when we solve this, we are getting a value of 56643 Newton. So F1 is greater now, so F1 minus F2 will give us the value of total resultant force F. Okay. Greater minus, minus. So F2 is this value and it will act at 2/3, that is 0.67. It will act at 1.33 from bottom. It will act 0.6767 mm from bottom. So it is written, right? Yes, it is written. So F2 will act at 2/3, 0.61 from the bottom. Okay. So the resultant water pressure, what is that? F is equal to F1 minus F2. So just compare and you will get the answers. So direct substitution problems. Okay. So now to find the reaction. Okay. What we have to do? We have to find that the where the reaction X, where the force, the resultant force will be acting. Okay. So what we are doing? We have to find the resultant force where it is going to act. So F1 is h1/3, F2 is h2/3. What about the resultant force where it is acting? So for that, what we are doing, F2 into x, it should be equal to f1/h1/3 minus f2/h2/3. Simple. Okay, so force into, so we want this distance, this is nothing but this is a distance divided by 3 only, but the value we don't know. So what we are doing, so F1 is 1, F1 into 4/3, F2 into 2/3 is equal to F into X. So when we solve this problem, we solve this relation, we are getting the X value is 1.55 meter. So what is this 1.55 meter? Here the resultant force, the resultant will act at 1.55. The force F also will act and also the resultant will be act. Resultant is by the hinges. The resultant reaction is by hinges. The force will be by, the force is provided by the water pressure. So from the same formula, P is equal to F/2 sin θ. So F is what? This one, 2 sin θ. So we are getting the P force. So R is equal to P. We are getting the R also. R is 16992. So this R is what? It is the resultant force, resultant reaction, you can tell it. So if RT and, so we will take RT and RB. See, the RT and RB are the reaction at the top and bottom, just given in the question only. RT and RB are the reaction at top and bottom hinges. Then this RT plus RB. So this RT plus RB will be equal to what? The resultant. So we got the resultant here. That is what? 169928. Okay. So now what we do? We have to find the reactions. RT and the S2, RB S2. How we can find the reactions? We have to take moment here. We will take a moment about the lower end. That is what we did in the previous slide, no? So we are comparing with that. We will take a reaction at the bottom hinges. So when we take the bottom hinges, what we are doing? So when we take reaction at RB. Maintaining that as equilibrium, what will happen? RT, right? So this RT into 6 meter, correct? Plus RB is there, right? So it's RB. At R, it will be 0 only. So to confirmation, I am showing into 0 is equal to, so RT will only act, okay? RT into 6 plus RB here. It will be 0 if we not write that also, okay? So RT into 6 is equal to your reaction R. We already found the value of X is 1.55. So once we do, we are getting the value of RT. So see, if RT and RB are the reaction at top and bottom hinges, then RT plus RB is R. Taking moment about the hinge reactions RT, RB and R. So RT is equal to into 6, RB into 0. If we neglect it, also okay. So R is equal to 1.55, then RT will be 43898 Newton. So RB what? RB is equal to R minus RT. We are getting 126030 Newton. That is 126,030 Newton is the answer. So this is how we are finding the individual reactions of the gate, that is RT and RB, RT and RB, once we get the resultant reaction R. So similar type of problems will be there for your exam also, if the paper setter will give the questions on the log gates. Okay, it is very easy. You have to remember once, just compare with the standard log gate which I have shown you in the previous slides. Okay, so I hope you understand the concept of this log gates. So thank you. So this was about the log gates, and please like and subscribe my channel. Thank you. Have a good day.